I have been involved with this particular research in the Mumbai area. I feel very funny, you know, talking on the phone. I feel like a rock star. I should have punk hairs and other kind of things. In the last 7 years, I'm doing this research, and I have seen so much of the development that has taken place in this area, and still so much is going on, that it's almost impossible to create a generalized view. And yet, I will try to give you some ideas of what is happening and kind of present it at different level. My main focus is going to be a little bit on the mobile marketing and understanding the parts of the mobile marketing and using smartphone. So the phones that are becoming pretty much very quickly, I think in another two or three years, the phone that will start becoming the commonplace for everybody's pocket. So that will be the smartphone. And then we need to understand that how that smartphone is going to change the business world and how the different things can be done out there with an emphasis on marketing. Okay? So do you agree that mobile phone is going to change the way we do business? Okay, at a personal level, you can do a lot of things that you cannot do right now, which, by the way, can be done on the internet, but I think it's the lack of the internet in India, which has created the leapfrogging of the mobile phone, and you can do a lot more things at the personal level. What about the business levels? You know, the business applications. Okay, so once again, so doing the chipsets and the design of the chipsets, and what has happened is some of the computing power and as well as the software support that is needed to instantly give the feedback of the customers and changing things can be done rather on the smartphone, but cannot be done on the current phone, or the, which we call the feature phones at this point of time. So the smartphones, as you can see, are becoming more of small computers, but with a lot of different advantages. So what I'm going to do is, as I said, that I'm going to teach it at different levels. So I'm first going to talk a little bit about the mobile and the background of the mobile, which all of you probably are familiar with. But as a friend of mine and a great teacher whom I follow always says, that reputation never hurts. So I'm going to repeat that a little bit. So we're going to start with the mobile phone. We'll talk a little bit about the mobile marketing. And then clearly, the mobile marketing now has gone to a different level altogether, with what is known as the mobile apps or the mobile applications. With the invention of the smartphone and certain capabilities which are out there, the mobile apps has taken the world by the storm. You know, people talk about disruptive technology. Do you know what is a disruptive technology? Okay?
So I can use to read books, handbooks, mm-hmm.
Okay. So Kindle can be an example of Amazon Kindle can be an example of a disruptive technology, because the way or we perceive books have completely changed. Internet is an example of a disruptive technology because, you know, and I can go on forever on the properties of the internet, but at least what it has done is it immediately broke down the barrier of the place, it broke down the barrier of the distance, and as a result made the world accessible to each other, and a lot of new business models could develop because of that. Similarly, a disruptive technology, mobile phone itself is a disruptive technology, but then iPhone or the Apple came in the market with quote-unquote another disruptive technology, where they introduced a particular product without even knowing that how successful it is going to be. And they introduced the product, and yes, it was cool, and it was really wonderful, and a lot of features and everything. But then a group of jailbreaking people, meaning the people who wanted to go around Apple and wanted to put their own software out there, created this wonderful platform, and Apple realized that, hey, there's money to be made out of that. And then they started supporting it, calling it the applications or the mobile apps. And mobile apps in the smartphone area has become the main propeller for growth. They really, really started putting the smartphone in a different platform altogether. So that is a disruptive technology. Electronic mail is an example of a disruptive and killer applications. You know, so certain things. So we'll talk a little bit about the mobile apps. We have to understand a little bit about the mobile value chain. So we have to understand a little bit about the mobile value chains, because then you will see some of the challenges that we have for the mobile area and to adapt the mobile marketing or mobile services, that how the value chain comes into the picture, who becomes a more powerful player, and how does it, you know, kind of either help or impedes the penetration of the mobile services. We'll talk a little bit about some of the real values that have been added by this thing, location-based services. We'll talk a lot about the brand awareness and engagement, so in the marketing, and then, you know, a little bit about the US and other. So mobile phone, what is a mobile phone? It's an electronic device that allows it to do a communication over a cellular network. As you can see, over a period of time, the mobile phone, you know, has gone from this. A lot of you, I'm sure none of you have seen this, because we are just too young, we are not born when we use this. And believe me, that phone like that, which used to be called a mobile phone. But if you look at the way that evolution has taken place, it is almost similar to this kind of evolution. So which has taken years actually has been done in a matter of, what is it? Not even 30 years, even less than that. I mean, yeah, 20, 22 years. What is the difference between the first generation to second to the third? There's mainly the speed of data transfer, okay? So why couldn't we support that, you know, huge amount of data on the 1G? The fundamental difference between 1 and 2G, 2, 3 and 4G are, in the fundamental, in the 1 and 2G side, we typically had what is known as opposite to digital communication.
Analog
communications. And the digital communications consist of only two things. Ones and zeros, or in other words, binary numbers. And as a result, it doesn't matter whether it is going to be the sounds, it is going to be the pictures, whether it's going to be the voices, everything gets converted into the ones and zeros. And as a result, exactly the same transport, the same pipeline, the same network, whatever you want to call it, they can very efficiently send this data from one point to another point. So you do not have to just think about it, that, you know, if we had to create, which I think is a singularly good idea after getting into the auto of Calcutta, if we could create the separate lane for auto, if we had to create a separate lane for the cars, and then separate lane for the Innovas, and the separate lane for the trucks, and all of those kind of things, then do you see that the requirements that's going to be? On the other hand, if we put all of them on the same road, what happens? A huge traffic jam, because there is a lot of delay that is caused by the others, and you really, really cannot control that. So in the analog area, what has happened is that you had to have a separate line because of the frequency mixing and all of these technical things, but you have to have a separate line. You have to have, just like, you know, we have to have a telephone line, then you have to have a cable line, and you have to have other things coming in. Now, when you put that into the digital spectrum, and as well as increasing the frequencies and changing the architecture, the way technology is done, then suddenly you can compress and push in a lot more data on the same line. So the voice was a circuit switching technology, whereas data is a
packet switching
technology. Excellent. So, and on the packet switching technology, when you go in, then you can actually pump in a lot more and a lot more efficiently. So that is what has happened. And as a result of that, we are actually getting more and more data support. And because of that, now we can do things that could not be done before. So going from 1 to 2, 2.5, and then finally getting into 3G and the 4G. So that means that's also changing, and the amount of data that we can send is also changing, right? Rather rapidly. So all of those things are giving rise to, you know, different things. So how it has changed? Ubiquitous connections to others, you know. I always tell a story that, you know, mobile phone has done wonders to us, but it has created us a globally connected and a locally disconnected person. So anyway, so ubiquitous connections to others. Chatting through SMS on network, right? Again, a lot of connections, a lot of ways of doing things. Telegram in the phone. The mobile phone has become, you know, later on we'll call it, but on the personal trusted device, the PTD. Okay? Sometimes I also, there's another term that we use for that, and it's called a lifestyle device, which when you abbreviate goes to LSD. It is drug, isn't it? The addiction to the mobile phone, I think the LSD is a better word compared to the personal trusted device. So a lifestyle device has become, so calendar, note checking ability, all kinds of things. In fact, it's interesting that I'm doing a little research on finding the applications of the mobile phone on the small and micro enterprises of India. And a lot of them actually told me that the facility that they want is the conversation recording, which means that when they're talking, they want to record the conversation. I said, why? You know, do you like want to sue the other person and take it? No. Because oftentimes we are on the bus or in a crowded place. It's very noisy. And this people is saying, you know, Dr. Babu, you know, that order that you had, oh, it's not going to be 500 pieces, it's going to go to 650 pieces. Okay? And then, you know, you didn't hear that, and it's 450 pieces. And then later on, we are going to have a fight. No, you did say that. No, you didn't say that. So it's much easier to record that than go to a quiet place and then basically listen to what has been said. Now, how many of you know that that particular facility exists in most of the phones? Okay. A 90% of the SME owners didn't know that.